Hi friends, so far we have covered 65 interview questions. We see some more today. What is protocol? Protocol is a set of methods and property declarations. Those are expected to be implemented in adapting class. This is the example of the protocol. Protocol contains a protocol keyword and the protocol name. It has 5 methods and 3 variables. Here if you see, the methods does not have body. And similarly, the variables does not have the value. We can specify the what kind of variables those are, whether those are settable or gettable or only gettable. Must be gettable, we cannot have a property with only set. And method declarations. Can we declare properties in protocol? Yes, we can declare properties in protocol. Okay, those we need to specify either those are get or get and set. Okay. If you see A where, B where and result are the properties, we are telling what kind of properties those are. Don't assign the values for the properties of protocol. Values are expected to be assigned in adapting class. Okay, this is how we declare protocol, and protocol contains set of method declarations as well as the variable declarations. Can we declare optional methods in the protocol? Yes, we can declare optional methods in protocol. Use @OBJC. In front of protocol keyword and @OBJC optional in front of the method name. Here we have to use @OBJC optional in front of method name, and in front of protocol name you have to use @OBJC. By default methods are required. By default methods as well as the variables are required. If you want to have optional methods, this is how we declare. What is the default method types? By default, all methods in a protocol are required. Those are expected to be implemented in adapting class. When you define a number of methods, let's say 4 methods, you are adapting in a class. When you are adapting in a class, you must define all the methods if those are required. If you want to mark them as optional, you have to use @OBJC optional. How to adapt protocols? Can we adapt multiple protocols? Yes, we can adopt multiple protocols. See the protocol declaration here. I have one protocol which is having one required method, one required property, and one optional method. Write a name after the class name. How to adopt it? Class, I am adopting my arithmetic protocol in a calculator class. The arithmetic protocol contains a set of methods. Out of that, the required methods I have implemented here. The optional method, mul, is not implemented. That is optional. If you require, you can implement. If you don't require, you simply ignore it. Adapting multiple protocols by separating with the comma. You can adapt multiple protocols. Arithmetic protocol is the one, comma, another protocol. You have to define the methods which are required. Options are optional methods. What is the advantage of protocol? By default, Swift does not support multiple inheritance. To achieve the multiple inheritance, we can use the protocols. Like here we are having two classes, right? Two protocols. Two classes, it doesn't work. Inheritance from the two superclasses doesn't work. To achieve that, we have to go for the protocols. And the second advantage is to achieve delegation decision pattern. Basically, delegation is communication between the two one-to-one objects. Communication between two objects. To achieve that, we go for the protocols. Can delegates be strong while declaring a delegation, while achieving the delegation pattern? The delegating object should be weak, otherwise it creates a return cycle. We see what exactly the return cycle going forward. Can we extend protocols? Extend means extension. By using extension, can we extend it? Yes, we can extend protocols to provide default implementations. Default body you can provide so that whenever you are adapting a protocol, you don't need to implement the method. If you implement, the implemented method gets called. If you don't implement, the default methods which you have defined by using extension, those are called. What is extension? It is a way to add methods to an existing class without subclassing. How generally we extend the class? By using inheritance, we extend. Alternative to that is extension. You don't need to use the inheritance subclassing mechanism to add the functionality. To add the functionality, you can go for the extension. How to see? For example, I want to add some methods to the string. Extension string, the method name is character at index reverse string. These two methods are not there in the string class actually. These two are not there in the string class. me make it. Let me make it clear. Bring it to single line. Yeah, I have a string class, so I am adding two methods here. Adding additional functionality. Generally, how we add additional functionality? By using inheritance or subclassing. Both are same. Inheritance, subclassing. Instead of that, we can use the extension to add additional functionality. So that by using string class object, you can call these methods. Character index, reverse string. The logic, you can think of it. This is how we access the index. This is how we reverse the string. What is the difference between extension and inheritance? It is definitely a question. Okay, extension, in extensions, what is the purpose of extension or subclassing? To extend the functionality, that is common. The difference here is overriding is not allowed in extension, whereas in classes, okay, by using inheritance, we can add the overriding methods. And functionality added using extension is available to all instances of that class. Let's say if I add two methods to a string, wherever you create string object, you can access these two objects additionally. Functionally added using subclassing is only available to the subclass. Let's say if I create one more subclass for the string, that is advanced string. If you create object of advanced string only, you can access the reverse string and character index. If you create object of normal string, you do not access the additional capabilities which you have declared and defined in the advanced string. Okay, that is the difference. Get the additional functionality by using the existing class instances. Existing class means in the string, use the same string class object and get the additional functionality. Need to create the subclass object to get the additional functionality. If you want to get the additional functionality, you have to create the advanced string object. Okay, if you define a inheritance or subclassing concept. What is ARC? What is ARC? ARC is automatic reference counting available in iOS to manage the memory of the application automatically. ARC is a compile time mechanism to manage the memory of an application. It is compile time mechanism. How exactly it works is, you have written code earlier, the developer used to manage the code. Now, as and when ARC comes into picture from iOS 5 onwards, we don't need to bother about the writing code and managing the memory. Okay, here ARC takes care of everything. How it takes care of everything? In manual memory management, developer used to write retain, release, strong, dealloc method. Those are the methods we used to write. Now, if you don't find them, because ARC is in the picture. How exactly it works? Once you write the code without release retain messages, the ARC system, after compiling the code, the ARC system puts the object release, object retain, object release, object equal to nil. Whatever developer used to do, that thing will be done by ARC in the compile time. In the compile time, not in the runtime. You remember that. ARC keeps track of reference counting of the objects. When reference counting becomes zero, then the ARC releases the object. This is the concept. Basically, ARC works in a compile time, and also it works on the retain count or reference count. If the reference count of the object becomes zero, the ARC system releases the memory. What is retain cycle? ARC system fails to release memory of the objects which are strongly pointing each other. Person is strongly holding the heart, and heart object is strongly holding the person. If ARC system tries to release the person, it tells, I am strongly pointing to the heart, first release the heart. ARC system comes here, tries to release the heart. Here we have a property, I am pointing strongly a human. Again, the ARC system comes here, the runtime system. So, it happens a cycle. Okay, it is called retain cycle. It prepares a cycle, it is called retain cycle. How to avoid a retain cycle? You can avoid a retain cycle by using weak keyword. It is simply a heart class is having a property called person. Person class is having a property called heart. Okay, then both are pointing each other strongly by default. Those are strong. If you make it weak, the IRC system tries to release the memory, it gets released. If these two are strong, the heart will not allow to release the person will not allow to release the heart in case of strong. So at least one pointer, one property should be weak. What is weak? Weak is a keyword which does not increase the reference count of that object when it is shared or passed as an argument. Weak objects must be optional. You remember this? What is weak? Whenever you are sharing an object, let's say I am having a property called let a mobile equal to mobile. I am creating one more property, let b mobile equal to a mobile. What I am doing? I am assigning the a mobile to the b mobile. How many objects we have created here? Mobile is only one. But there are two owners. A mobile is pointing to the same mobile, B mobile is pointing to the same mobile. If I release the A mobile, what happens? The reference count becomes in case of strong, what happens when you assign it? Let A mobile equal to mobile, the object reference count is 1. When you make let B mobile equal to A mobile, the reference count becomes 2. If you release one object, the other object is still pointing. So the memory, again you need to release. Okay, in case of weak, what happens? Let a mobile equal to mobile, mobile one mobile is created, the reference count is 1. When you make let b mobile equal to a mobile, if b mobile is weak, what happens is the reference count will not be increased. The b is depending on the a. If a is released, automatically the b is gone. In case of strong, the reference count increases. In case of weak, the reference count will not be increased. The owners are shared. The mobile is shared between A and B, but the reference count is not increased. I will show you it whenever we come to the challenging. I will show you what is the return cycle, how to avoid that programmatically. What is unwound? Unwound is similar to weak, but never becomes nil. So it should not be an optional. Weak must be an optional, right? It should not be an optional. Use unwound in closures when you are sure that object never becomes nil. It is similar to weak only. Even in unwound also, it doesn't increment the reference count. But it should never be nil. In case of weak, it can be nil. So that we have to use the optional. What is the difference between arrays and sets? Array is an ordered collection of similar or dissimilar elements. Set is an unordered collection of unique elements. This is the major difference. Similar or dissimilar elements, it is order. Unique elements with no order. Array elements are accessed using by index. Set doesn't contain any index or key to access an element. It is just a bag. You can simply take values, but you cannot specify, give me the particular element in case of set. In case of array, you can specify, give me the object at given index 5. Array allows to access particular element by using index. Swift does not, set doesn't contain, doesn't allow to access particular element as there is no index, there is no key. Array is a bit slower when iterating through the collection. Set is faster when iterating through collection. The performance wise, sets are faster compared to array. Use array when order is important. Use set when order is not important. When order is not important, and if you want to perform a operation on the all the elements, you cannot perform an operation on particular element in a set, because you cannot access a particular element. If you want to access all elements. Tuples versus dictionary. This is again one more important interview question. Tuples groups multiple values together. We have already discussed tuples. Dictionary is a collection of key value pairs. It is unordered collection of key value pairs, dictionary. Tuple does not have any methods to perform operations, whereas a dictionary is a structure which has enough methods to perform operation. In case of dictionary, it is a collection. You can add, you can remove, you can replace. Those methods are available in the dictionary, but on the tuples, it is not there. Here also group multiple values grouping together. Here also almost similar. Tuples are used to return multiple values from a method. The exact usage of tuple is to return multiple values from a function or a method. Dictionary is used to store collection of key value pairs. Okay. Note, dictionary keys are unique. The keys in a dictionary are unique. what is fall through. Fall through is a keyword used in switch statement. If fall through exists in a successful case, it executes the next case irrespective of the case value match. Here, see, I have fall through here. I am passing 10 here. If we pass 10, this is successful. In a successful case, I have fall through. If we are having a fall through in a successful case, it executes the next case irrespective of the condition. We have passed 10, but how many, what is printed here? This is 10. It is bigger than 10. It is bigger than 10 means the next case we are passing. But actually, the 10 value is not matching here. Okay, this is important. Is optional enum or structure? We have options, right? Whether that is enum or structure. Actually, optional is of type enum. It is enum. It internally contains two properties. We see that. How to declare a selector in a Swift? Selector, what is selector? Selector is a pointer to a method to hold some method in a pointer. Okay, how to use that? Hash selector class name dot abc. Class name you have to mention and method name. This is the method name. This is method name. You don't need to put any braces. How to check the variable type? I have one variable. I want to check what is the type of it. Okay. Is, we can check is by using is a key. Is an operator which checks the type of a variable. I have declared a equal to 10. I am checking here if a is int. If it is int, print this. If it is not int, don't print it. How to call a method with some delay? I want to call a method after 5 seconds or 10 seconds. How to call it? Dispatch queue dot main dot async after. You have to give from the current time plus 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, call this method. Method call. Okay. The same thing can be done by using timer. You can schedule a timer for after 5 minutes. What is KVO or KVC? There are two things. It is very, very important. You will definitely have this question in interview. Key value observing is a process of observing the changes in an object or variable. You are keeping tracking of a variable change. Assuming that I have a account holder and account bank account. When there is a change in balance, I'll get notified. The user gets notified. The similar mechanism when there is a change in a particular object, those can be observed by another object. The changes gets notified through observe value method. There is some method called observe value, new value, old value, different we have. Okay, we have one method that gets called when there is a change in a particular element. First of all, we have to register that. We see when we come to the coding challenge. Key value coding. What is key value coding? Key value coding is a process of accessing properties of an object by using keys. Let's say I have one property in a mobile case, mobile class. The property name is model. How do you access the model here? I am creating one mobile. Mobile.model, I'll get the 2018. Mobile.model equal to 2019, I am setting. These two statements can be done by using this. You don't need to write any extra code here. By using key value coding, you can set it. We are accessing here, it prints 2018 here. Okay, and when you are setting the value 2019, you are setting. This is similar to this. Okay, by using key value coding, this is how you access. Whenever you are using key value coding, it should be NS object as a super class. How to access private variables of a class outside? How do you access private variables? By using key value coding, you can access, you can check it actually. By using key value coding, assume that this is a private variable, I want to access it outside. If you access my mobile.model, it gives you error. This is private variable, you cannot access. By using key value coding, it allows. This works. You can check it. It is a hack. How to write singleton in Swift? How do you write a singleton in Swift? What is singleton exactly? It is again a very, very important question. Singleton is an object which we make sure that only one instance exists in application entire life cycle. In entire application life cycle. Once you run the application, an object will be created. If you're having 10 view controllers, wherever you call, the same instance will be returned. That will not create again and again. The instance, only one instance exists at entire application lifecycle. See how I have here. Class database. In my application, I have one database. In 10 views, I want to access that database. You cannot create 10 databases for each view controller one. You will create one database, the same database shared among the 10 view controllers. How to do that? Class database. I have two functions. One is clean, another one is save. I have one variable static let db manager of type database equal to database. I am creating one instance of this class and making that as static. How to access that static, right? Class name, on top of class name we need to call database dot db manager dot save or clean. These are the instance methods. This is instance only, right? We are creating instance and we are creating instance within a same class. Same class instance we are creating and assigning to the static variable. Okay. I am calling database dot db manager. I can call and save operation in view controller one, and in view controller 2 also I can save. In view controller 3 I can clean. Again in view controller 4 I can save. Database is only one. I am making sure that to perform any operations, you create the database.dbManager. How do you make sure singleton is created only once? This is class only, right? Outside also I can create let database equal to database of database initializer. In view control 2 also I can make it let database equal to database of database initializer. Then what is the difference between singleton and regular class? If you have regular class, you can create a number of objects. If you have singleton class, you need to make sure that multiple number of objects will not be created. Okay, how do you make sure the initializer, you have to make it as private. If you make the initializer private from outside the class, you cannot access. If you want to access, you have to use database.dbManager.functions on properties. Okay, what's new in Swift 5? We see that we have covered almost 93 interview questions. These are well enough, more than enough in a Swift. The iOS interview questions we see. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Please do subscribe, share it. Thank you.